Hello world and welcome to Microsoft Unboxed. Every week we're bringing you stories of Microsoft technology and the people behind that technology. I'm Colleen O'Brien and I'm joined by my co-host, Sonia Dara.
Hello.
I have a story, Sonia has a story, but we have no idea what each other's story is. The theme for today's show is tech in manufacturing. To be honest, I don't really know anything about manufacturing.
I mean, how could you not?
But I do love a factory tour. I have been on so many factory tours. Really? I have been to the Theo Chocolate Factory.
I have done that one.
Right
as
here
well.
In Seattle.
Lots
I have been to the Tillamook Creamery.
It's cheese, right?
Yes, delicious cheese. And I've been to the Tabasco Factory on Avery Island in Louisiana.
You said it so spicy.
It was very right. Spicy. I love to see all the machinery. I love to see the history of the factory.
Just like a spoonful of hot sauce, or did you get to put it on?
No, you know those little like miniature Tabasco sauces?
Yeah. I grew up in Atlanta, so I've been to the Coca-Cola factory / museum. They have this fountain area where you'd normally have like your regular sodas you'd try, but then they have it from all around the world. They would warn you, but also kind of bet you to try this one called Beverly, which is a Coca-Cola beverage in Italy. It is so bitter, and I remember as like kindergartner, I'd trick my friends and be like, I got you a Sprite.
Well, clearly that is the extent of our factory and manufacturing knowledge.
No, breweries are technically factories.
Okay, you're
right. We have a lot of breweries in Seattle. I've been to many of them with you. Yeah.
That is true. One of the reasons why we're talking about tech and manufacturing today is because Microsoft has a presence, is over in Germany at Hannover Messe, which is the biggest manufacturing conference in the world. Hannover Messe will take place on April 1st through the 5th in Germany, and Microsoft is gonna have a big booth there on location. One example of tech-optimized operations in the factory of the future.
Factory of the future, I'm picturing the Jetsons.
Yes, is Tetra Pak. Tetra Pak offers processing, packaging, and service solutions, maintaining the highest standards of food safety. They help factory owners better manage how their supply chain, how their manufacturing process is working. In a supply chain, if one part breaks down, it can stop the entire assembly line, the entire packaging process for days on end. And sometimes the part in the machine that you need is not even in your country. So to solve this problem, Tetra Pak has connected packaging lines to the Microsoft Azure cloud to help predict informed maintenance timing. So like predicting when this issue is going to occur so people can get ahead of it. They're looking at everything from the pressure that's getting applied to these sensors, the temperature of them, and that's what allows them to do these types of predictions. And because Tetra Pak services a ton of different factories, they can look at trends across those factories.
I wish they could predict things like that going wrong in like my life. Hey, Sarah, you remember that time you messed up doing this? Don't do it again.
Aren't you reading your horoscope?
Do you believe in that?
Kind of.
Colleen O'Brien, I'm disappointed.
I just think it's fun. And in addition to all of these analytics, they're equipping service engineers with HoloLenses. Right on the factory floor, a great and tenured and knowledgeable expert help you get through the maintenance cost and time-saving initiative here.
I'm going to talk about a company called Bueller. I hope it's called Bueller because I always think of Ferris Bueller's Day Off, which is by far one of my favorite movies ever. My best friend's sister's boyfriend's brother's girlfriend heard from this guy who knows the kid who's going with the girl who saw Ferris pass out 31 flavors last night. Anyways, Bueller. So we talk about this proverbial needle in a haystack. How about thinking now about how do you find a poisonous kernel within a truckload of corn?
That is a much more dangerous game.
There is this highly carcinogenic mold called Aflatoxin. If one grain is infected, it can poison the entire harvest. It can sicken and even potentially kill people or animals.
How often is this happening? Like, do we need to be
all
worried?
The time. All the time. We are worried.
We're worried. Are we appropriately worried or are we worried enough?
So here's, it gets worse.
Oh my
you can't
God.
See it, You can't smell it, and you can't taste it. On top of that, it can't be destroyed by heat. So just like heating anything up that you would think would normally destroy bacteria, mold is not susceptible to that.
How do you get rid of it?
You're so concerned.
You just told me there's a corn kernel.
Oh, this can grow on more than just corn. Sorry, it's on everything. Dried fruit.
We have dried fruit right here.
I know, there is dried mango staring at us right now. I know. Okay, but don't worry. You know, she's sweating and it's making me sweat.
Can we get to the good part?
There's still some more bad parts to it. So with climate change coming in, the mold is actually expanding to the north because the stresses on the crops make them more susceptible to mold. Bueller has actually, since 1965, been trying to combat this, and they've had patents out there for like a sorting machine that can help sort out the grains, but it was just not commercially viable because it was incredibly slow, and still you had to throw out a big chunk of healthy harvest they just weren't sure had been contaminated, right? In 2016, though, Bueller challenged their employees to an innovation competition. Ben Diefholz comes into play.
He's the hero of this story.
He, along with a bunch of his other teammates, created what is called Lumo Vision. They feed grain into a hopper, and it creates this vibratory feeder. It sends all the grains down the chute at like a really ridiculous speed, 11.5 feet per second. And then what they have is this really powerful camera above, and they actually have UV light. There's this fluorescence that comes off the mold. It illuminates it, and then air jets that essentially shoot the bad kernels out into basically rejection.
I was hoping you were gonna say like some laser.
They're able to do 10 to 15 tons of maize in 1 hour. And it's improved from what used to be 25% that would end up getting chucked to only 5%. So right now it's just with maize, but they're looking to expand to peanuts, rice, dried fruit, which I said are still kind of susceptible to it.
Oh my gosh.
Crazy, right? It's like ping, ping. Jets and light. So at Ignite 2018 last year, Satya announced Bühler Insights. It's the first secure, reliable, and intelligent cloud-based digital services in food and feed processing. They're integrating blockchain technology into their platform so you can actually trace where the food has come from the farm all the way to the grocery store. All players along the supply chain can tell if their grains are verified and safe.
I'm feeling a little bit better.
A little bit better,
this.
Right?
Yeah.
It was like kind of end of the world for a moment, but
we're okay.
Bueller's gonna help us out. Save Ferris.
I feel like the right people are focused on this whole tech and manufacturing thing. They're ready for the smart factory beyond Industry 4.0.
And I feel safer to eat my mangoes now.
I don't know if I'm there yet.
You'll get there.
We are about ready to transition to our final segment, Outside the Box. I am going to ask a question that has been submitted by you, our audience, and Sonia here is going to have 30 seconds to answer. YouTube viewer Jeff Mann asks, what is the working environment like at Microsoft?
It's fun. Basically like a college campus out here at Redmond. I think my day gets to start pretty easy. It's not this crazy, has to be 9 to 5. I get to interact with a lot of my teammates and we collaborate a lot of times during the day. So I'm not just sitting at my desk solo. I think a really nice collaborative working environment. And we get to do this. I think I'm related to Goofy. Our next question comes from YouTube viewer Andrew. If you could go anywhere in the world, where would you go and why?
New Zealand. Because my brother's there right now.
Oh, he went from Korea to New Zealand?
Yeah, he's been living internationally for many years now, and I miss him. I would really like to see him.
New Zealand's also pretty cool, too.
Yeah, I'm traveling very vicariously through all of his social media posts right now. Thank you to our viewers for submitting those great questions. If you have something you want to ask us, just submit your question below or comment below.
And remember to subscribe to our channel. We're gonna have fresh new episodes right off the factory floor every Thursday at 9 a.m. Pacific, so make sure you tune in. I have to do the thumbs up.
I know, it is awkward until we do that.
Yeah.
Or maybe it has more awkward when we do it. Hey everyone, if you can't get enough of us, I would highly recommend subscribing to our podcast, Women in Business and Technology, available right here.
And you can follow us on Twitter and Instagram at our social handles right here.